Good morning students, welcome you all in the class 9th. Today we are going to learn our maths first topic, number system. Okay, so in the part of the introductions we will see first what is natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, then rational numbers, irrational numbers, odd numbers, even numbers, prime number, composite number and co-prime number. So everyone, we have already learned about these all types of number in the previous class. Okay, so then here the first natural number. So count, natural number means what? The counting numbers means that we can count from where we are counting the numbers, that numbers counting from 1, 2, 3 and so on, that right. So such numbers are called natural numbers and it is denoted by letter N, right. The next, whole numbers. So if the set of natural, in the set of the natural numbers, if we add 0 means with all the natural numbers together with the 0, that numbers are called whole numbers and it is denoted by letter W, right. Next, integers. And integers, everyone know that integers, all the positive and negative numbers. Integers is denoted by letter Z. So we have already learned about the integers. So integers means what? All the natural numbers, 0 and the negative of all natural numbers, such a collection of all numbers is called integers. Okay? So and it is denoted by letter Z. Then next, rational numbers. So rational numbers means what? The numbers such a we can express in the form of P by Q. Okay, so this number we can write in the form of P by Q. It means that, you know, what is the form P by Q? That is fraction form, the numerator and denominator. And here such a condition is what? Where Q is not equals to 0. Right, this condition is very important for the number can be a rational number. Understood? So rational number means what? The number that we can express in the form of the P by Q, where Q is not equals to 0. Such numbers are called rational number and it is denoted by letter Q. Right? Capital Q. Then irrational numbers. Irrational number means what? The numbers which we cannot express in the form of P by Q. So such numbers are called irrational numbers, right? So irrational number, it is denoted by letter I. Okay. Then here, next, odd numbers. So odd numbers means what? We have learned already from this even number, odd number, then prime number, composite number from the class 3rd, 4th, right? So these odd numbers, means what? The numbers which are not divisible by 2. So such numbers are called odd numbers. And what is mean by even number? The numbers which we can, the numbers which can divisible by 2. So such numbers are called even number, right? Next, prime numbers. What are the prime numbers? Prime number means the numbers which has only the divisor is that number itself and 1. Correct? Means the numbers which has factors are only 1 and number itself, such a numbers are called prime number. For example, here 2, suppose we will take the 2. In which table that 2 will come? So 2 comes in which table? Only 2, means the factor of 2 is 2 itself and 1. So 1, 2 are 2 and 2, 1 are 2, like this, right? So these prime numbers, 2 has the factors are 2 and 1. So this number is called prime number. Next prime number supposed to be 3. So 3 having the factors are 3 and 1, means number itself and 1, means this number is divisible by these both 2 numbers only. Correct? Means number itself and 1. So such numbers are called prime number. Afterwards, composite number. So composite number means what? Suppose we will take this number 4. Okay, so 4 is the composite number, means 4 having the factors are that one, it is one of the factors. This always, every number having the one is a factor. Then its number itself. Then afterward, this four comes in which table? Two tables, right? So more than two factors are there. It means that the numbers which has having the factors are number means more factors than the number now one and the number itself. There are if supposed to be the other factors are there, then such numbers are called composite number. Understood? Next, co-prime numbers. Co-prime number means what? A pair of number. Here, co-prime numbers are the pair of numbers which the pair of number supposed to be, we will take that 2 and 3. These two numbers means this is the pair of number. Okay, so why we can say these two numbers are co-prime numbers or pair of this number is called co-prime number? Because their HCF is 1. Okay, means the common factor of these two numbers is 1. See, here the factorization of these two will there 2 into 1 and here for the 3, 3 into 1. So what is the common factor is here? 1. So what is the HCF of these two numbers is 1. So the number of pair of numbers whose HCF is 1, such numbers are called co-prime numbers. Understood everyone? Now we will see to find out the rational numbers between the two rationals. Okay, so there are the 1, 2, 3, 4 methods are there to find out the rational numbers between the two rationals. Okay, or two rational numbers. So in these 4 methods, first we will see mid value method. Okay, so one example, find the rational number between 3 and 4. So how to find out the rational number between 3 and 4 by which method? Mid value method, right? Now these two numbers, these 3 and 4 are the two rationals. Okay, so 3 and 4 are the two rational means how we can express this 3? 3 by 1 and 4 is what? 4 by 1, right? So these 3 and 4 are the two rationals. Then how we can find out the rational number between these two numbers? Okay, so suppose we will take this let which R and S means R and S are two rationals. Okay, mean these two rationals. Then how to find the mid values of these two rational numbers? So R plus S by 2. Okay, so the mid value of these two numbers will be there. We can express in the form R plus S by 2. Okay, so we will find out the rational number between these two numbers 3 and 4 by this methods, rational mid value method, like this. See, here you have these two numbers 3 and 4. Correct? So here this 3 plus 4 by 2, right? So 3 plus 4 by 2 means what? Equals to 7 by 2, right? So here this 7 by 2 is the number between 3 and 4. Means 7 by 2 is the rational number between these two rationals 3 and 4. Okay, so here what we can write the numbers, this 3 which is less than 7 by 2 and this 7 by 2 which is less than 4. Right, now how these divisions come? See, 7 by 2 means if you divide this 7 by 2 like this, so 2 1s are 2, 3s are 6, 1 remaining, that 0.2 5s are 10, right? So 3.5. So if you will verify this, so 3 is less than 3.5 and 3.5 means what? 7 by 2 which is less than 4. Okay, so these numbers 7 by 2 lies between the 3 and 4. Okay, next example, find a rational number between minus 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. Now we know that here what R plus S by 2 okay, R plus S by 2 means R and S are what? These two rational numbers, this R and S, okay. So R plus S by 2, that this lies between, is a rational number. Lies between which two numbers? R and S. Okay, R plus S by 2. This is the rational number lies between R and S. Now we have to find rational numbers between minus 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. Right? By which method? Mid value method. Right? So here we will take this two numbers R plus S. So minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. R plus S divided by what? 2. Okay. So here we have to make the denominator same. Everyone knows that how to make the denominator same. So here I will do this minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. So how to make the denominator same? By the same method or 2 cross multiplication. So what is the LCM of this? 3, 4 are 12. So you have to multiply with 4. That is multiply by 4 here. Here to make 12 to multiply with 3. And here also 3. So you will get minus 4 plus 3, 1 are 3 by 4, 3 are 12. Now how much remaining? Minus 4 plus 3 minus 1 by 12. Okay. Minus 1 by 12. So here the values of this number came minus 1 by 12 and divided by this 2. Now 2 means what? How to write the 2 in the rational forms? 2 by 1. Afterwards you will get the reciprocal of your this denominator. Right? So here minus 1 by 12. Reciprocal means after means divide, 2 divide by this number. So when you will divide by this number to this number, then division will change into which sign? Multiplication. Means reciprocal will be of the this number. So what you will get? 2 by 1 means 1 by 2. So that is minus 1 upon 12 is 24. Right? So now this is the number that lies between minus 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. So how you will write here? Minus 1 by 3 is less than minus 1 by 24 and which is less than 1 by 4. So that is this number is lies between minus 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. Okay, now we will see how to find the, here we have find only the one number that is between the given two rational numbers. Now we will find how to find out the more numbers in between that two given rational numbers by mid value method. Okay. Now we will see how to find the rational six rational numbers between 3 and 4. Before we have learned how to find only one of the rational numbers between the given two rationals. Okay, now here we know that 3 by the mid value method what? R plus S by 2. So similarly we can take this number is R and this number is S, right? So here first 3 plus 4 by 2. So you will get 3 plus 4 is how much? This is 7, 7 by 2, right? So this is the 7 by 2 is the number between 3 and 4, right? Now next number we will take for the same. This new number you got here, 3 is less than 7 by 2 which is less than 4, right? For the next, what we will take? This 3 and 7 by 2. Okay, so 3 is one of the rational number, that is R for us, plus what is S? S we will take that 7 by 2 divided by 2. Okay, so 3 means what? You will write 3 by 1 plus 7 by 2. Here we have to make the denominators same. Multiply by 2. Right? Upon 2. 2 means 2 by 1. Like this. So here 3 2 जा 6, 6 plus 1, sorry, 3 2 जा 6 plus 7, how many? 13. So you will get 13 by 2 divided by 2 by 1. So afterwards, reciprocals of 13 by 2 upon into 1 by 2. So 13 by 4. So next number you got, that is the 13 by 4. Afterwards, we will take these two numbers, 7 by 2 and 13 by 4 to find out the next number. Okay, so next here, 7 by 2 and 13 by 4. So, plus 13 by 4. That is new R and S for us and divided by 2. So, here also to make the denominator same, multiply by 2, 2s are 4 and here 2s are, right? So 7 2 are 14, 14 plus 13 by 4. So 14 plus 13, how many you will get? 27, correct? So 27 by 4 upon 2 by 1, right? Now what will be the next step? 27 by 4 divided by 2 by 1 means that you will get the reciprocal of this number, right? So 27 by 4 into 1 by 2 will come, correct? So 27 by 4 divided becomes multiply and 2 by 1 will be there, 1 by 2. So in this way you will get 27 ones are 27 and 4 twos are 8. So your next number is that 27 by 8. Right now this number is like between which number? 7 by 2 and 13 by 4. Correct? Now afterwards we will take this 4 number and here 27 by 2. Understood? Next number we will take now. These two numbers we will take. 7 by 2 and 4 to find the next number. Okay? So here 4 and next number for this to find out the number between natural numbers 4 and 7 by 2. Right? So 4 is your R for this and 7 by 2 is S. So you will go for the way 4 by 1 plus 7 by 2 upon 2. Right? So here to make the denominator same. 4 2 are 8 plus 7 and divided by 2 is the denominator is same. So 8 plus 7, 15 by 2 divided by 2 by 1. Correct? So here 15 by 2, this divides with come multiply and reciprocal of this number. So 1 by 2, finally you will get 15 by 4. Now here when you have compared with these two numbers, this means when you have taken this number 7 by 2 and 4, so number between that 7 by 2 and 4 is what you got, 15 by 4. Understood? So to find out the next number, we will select this new number 7 by 2 and we got here 15 by 4. Understood? So now next are 7 by 2 and 15 by 4. So here this is R and this is S for us. Understood? So here 7 by 2 plus 15 by 4. So here we have to make the denominator same. So into 2 and divided by 2. Okay. So now after making the denominator same, 7 2 are 14. 14 plus 15. So how much you will get? 14 plus 15? 29. Correct. So 29 by 4. And here divided by 2 by 1. Right? So now 29 by 4. 2 by 1 becomes will be the 1 by 2. So finally you will get 29 upon 4 2s are 8. Okay. Now here this number we got the new number 29 by 8. That number is lying between these two numbers 7 by 2 and 15 by 4. And now finally we have to take this 15 by 4 and 29 by 8. These two numbers. Okay. So afterwards which number will come? 15 by 4 and
29 by 8. Okay, now here this 15 by 4 is R for us and 29 by 8 is S for us, right? So according to the mid value, so R plus S by 2, that is 15 by 4 plus 29 by 8 upon 2. So here you will get to make the denominator say 4 to the 8, right? So 15 to the 30. So this 30 plus 29. 30 plus 29, how much you will get? 59, correct? So this 59 by 8 divided by 2 by 1. So after simplifying this 59 by 8, this divides will come multiplied by 1 by 2. So finally you will get 59 by 8 to the 60. Now we got here new numbers, that how many are there? This 7 by 2, 1, then 2, 3, 4, this 5 and 6, that all the 6 numbers that lies between which number? 3 and 4. Understood? So now we will write here which are the numbers that we got, that between these two rational numbers 3 and 4. So here 7 by 2 comma 13 by 4, then 27 by 8, then afterwards 15 by 4, then 29 by 8, and last 59 by 16. These all are the numbers. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These 6 rational numbers between given the 2 rational numbers 3 and 4. Understood? Now we will see the next method. Which one method? Denominator method to find out the rational numbers between two given rational numbers. Okay. Okay, next method is denominator method to find out the rational number between the two given rationals. Okay, so denominator means in this method we have to find out the how many rational numbers between these two rational numbers? 8. Okay, so we have to convert the denominator of these two numbers, that is 8 plus 1. Okay, so that is 9. So we have to convert the denominator of these two numbers is into the 9. So what is the denominator for these two numbers? So 2 and means 2 we can express in the form of 2 by 1. And another number, that is the 3 by 1. Correct. So these two numbers having the denominators are 1 and 1. Now in this method, denominator method, if you have to find the 8 rational numbers, then we have to add plus 1 into this number, right? So here 8 plus 1, that is 8 plus 1 equals to 9, right? So we have to convert denominator to 9, correct? We have to convert denominator to 9. So what is the denominator here? 1, and here also 1. So we have to convert into the 9. So here we will write this 2 by 1 to multiply with, by which number we have to multiply? Yes, correct, it is with the 9. And here, so if you are multiplying the denominator with the 9, so we have to multiply with the numerator for the with the 9, correct? And next number is what? 3 by 1. So here also you have to multiply with 9, and here also you have to multiply with 9. So you will get 9 to the 18 upon 9, and next number 27 upon 9. So these are the two numbers, original number we have converted into this form with the denominator 9. Now how many numbers we want? 8 rational numbers. So we will find out between means we don't have to take these two numbers. Understood? So here which number will come after 18 by 9? You will get 19 by 9, then 20 by 9, then 21 by 9, 22 by 9, 23 by 9, 24 by 9, next will be the 25 by 9, and 20. 6 by 9 because we don't have to go next number after 27. We don't have to take also this 27 by 9. Now we will count up whether these numbers are all are 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So these are the numbers that 8 rational numbers lies between which numbers 2 and 3 by which method? Denominator method. Okay? Understood everyone? Now next question, next example is here. Find 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. If you will see here, these two rational numbers with the denominator is same. Correct? Then we have to find out here the 5 rational numbers between. So here 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. Correct? These two are the rational numbers with the denominator same. So is there any number in between that, if you will see this like this form? So we have to find out this. How many numbers should be there? 5 numbers. Okay. So here 5 rational numbers we want means denominator. We have to make actually. So 5 rational numbers means we have to take this 5 plus 1 equals to 6. So we have to multiply to this denominator by which number? 6. Okay. So here 3 by 5 and here another number is your 4 by 5. So here multiply with 6. Correct? So here 6 threes are 18 upon 30 and here 6 fours are 24 upon 6 5 are 30. Okay. Now we will find out the number between these two rational numbers. So here 19 by 30, then 20 by 30, then 21 by 30, 22 by 30, 23 by 30. Now 24 by 30 we cannot take. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are the 5 rational numbers between these 2 rational numbers. Okay. Now next method we will see which method? Numerator method. Okay. Now we will see the next method, numerator method. So find the 10 rational numbers between minus 1 by 9 and 4 by 9. So here what are the numerators? Minus 1 and 4, right? Here the numerators are minus 4 and 9. So when you have to find the 10 rational numbers between the given rational number, so what we have to do? We have to find out this 10 plus 1. 10 plus 1 you will get 11. So you have to multiply to the numerators of the given number with a particular number in such a way that the difference between these numerators at least 11. Understood? What? You have to multiply to this both the numerators with a particular number in such a way that the difference between these two numerators at least what you will get? 11, right? Now you have these two numbers minus 1 and here this is 4. Okay, if you will multiply with the number 1, then there is a no change, right? And if you multiply with the 2, so you will get here suppose this 2, then 4 2s are 8 and here 2 1s are 2. So difference between these two numbers at least should be what? 11, correct? Means 4 2s are 8. And here difference is what? 8 minus. What is the next number? Minus 2. So you are getting this 8 minus minus plus. So 8 plus 2, 10 you are getting. But you are, that should be what? At least 11. It can be greater, it's okay. But at least 11 should be there. So it is 10 is less than 11, right? So we will try to multiply with the next number is what? 3, right? So multiply by 3. So here you will get minus 3 and here 12. So 12 minus minus 3. So 12 minus minus 3 you are getting 15. 12 minus minus 3. So this minus minus is also 15. So 15 is a greater than 11, right? So we can take this number 3 to multiply both these fractions. Okay, so here minus 1/9, then multiply by 3, and here second number is 4/9 to multiply with 3. Okay, so minus 3 upon 27 here and 12 upon 27. So you will find out now here the number between these two numbers. So minus 3 by 27, so before number which one? Minus 2 by 27, then minus 1 by 27, then which number will come here? 0 will come, that is afterwards 1 by 27, 2 by 27, 3 by 27, again 4 by 27, 5 by 27, how many there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then 6 by 27, 7 by 27, 8 by 27, how many you got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So in this way, you can find out the rational number between the two given rationals. By which method? By numerator method. Understood? Now we will see the last method. When the denominators are not equal, then how to find the rational numbers between the given two rational numbers. Okay. Last method is what? When the denominators are not equal. So in this method, we have to find out the 7 rational numbers between 1 by 6 and 5 by 21. Okay, so 1 by 6 and 5 by 21. So here the denominators are not equal, correct? So when this such a method, we have to find out the LCM or to make the denominator same. Okay, so what is the LCM? LCM of 6 and 21. What is the LCM? Everyone knows that how to find the LCM, right? So here LCM came 42, correct? LCM is 42. So what we have to do? We don't have to multiply with the 42. We have to try to bring this denominator in which new number, that is 42, right? So here 1 by 6 and here 5 by 21. So how you can make the denominator 21 to 42? So by multiplying with 2. And here also we have to multiply with 2. And by which number you will multiply this to 6? Then you will get the 21 to 42. That is 7. 6 7s are 42. So here also we have to multiply with 7, right? So 7 here. 7 1s are 7. And 6 are 7, 6 7 are 42, and here 5 2 are 10, and here 42. Now, if you will see here 7 by 42 and 10 by 42, are you getting here 7, then afterwards 8 and 9? So, two numbers you will get 8 by 42 and 9 by 42, because we have to find the number between these two numbers. But how much requirements are there? We want 7 rational numbers, right? So, further multiplication we have to do for this, right? If you will multiply to 2, then you will get 7 2s are 14 and here 10 2s are 20. So, 14 and 20 in that, how many rational numbers? 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. How many you will get? See here, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, because we cannot take. So, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. But we want 7. So, still we have to increase the number to multiply with this rational number. So, we will finally multiply with which number? 3. And then we will find out the requirement of your numbers. Okay, so 7 3s are here 21, and here 3 2s are 6, and 3 4s are 12, right? And here 30 and here 126. Now if you will observe these two numbers, you can understand that what 21 and 30, in that how many numbers are there? 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28 and 29, these numbers. These numbers 21 and 30 mean that we can write the 7 rational numbers. Okay. So here next will be the 22 by 126, then 23 by 126, 24 by 126, then afterwards 25 by 126 and 26 by 126. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 27 by 126 and last 28 by 126. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. These are the required number that lies between the two rational numbers 1 by 6 and 5 by 21. Okay. Next part of this topic we will see on next lecture. Thank you.